Hello Python programmers, so this is another sorting algorithm video, and in this video we'll understand the bubble sort algorithm. So I don't think so I have to explain you that what sorting is. We have already done that in our previous video where we have understood the insertion sort and selection sort, so the link will be provided below in case you want to watch. So once again, this video is also split into two parts. In the first part, we'll see the theory part of how this bubble sort algorithm works. And in the second part, we'll actually create a Python program to see that how we can do this bubble sort. Okay, so let's start off with the theory part first. So let's say that I create a list, right? I create a list of unsorted elements. Now, let me write something random. I don't want to repeat. Okay, so let's say that this is the unsorted list we have provided, and we have to use the bubble sort algorithm to sort it. So how will that work? Now, bubble sort is one of the most simplest sorting algorithm, and it uses the concept of swapping. Okay, so it uses the concept of swapping. Now, what happens is we'll take the pair of elements, right? So first of all, we'll take the first two elements and we'll compare whether the first element is smaller than the second element or not. Obviously, we are doing this for ascending order. So we'll compare whether the first element is smaller than the second element or not. If the case is true, nothing will happen. There won't be any change in the list. Okay, now in the next part, we'll compare the second element with the third element. Now, the intention here is to push the largest number to the very end. Now, you'll see how that will happen. So, we'll compare these two elements. Now, 15 is obviously larger than 3. So, value will be swapped. This will become 0, 3, 15, 1, 2, and 12. Okay. Now, again, 15 will be compared to 1. Obviously, 15 is greater than 1, so value will be swapped. This will become 15, 2, and 12. Okay, then once again, 15 will be compared to 2 and 0, 3, 1. 15 is greater than 2. I don't think so I have to explain you this. Okay. And then 15 will be compared to 12. Now here, the first iteration is complete. This is the end of the first iteration. After the first iteration, the largest number is pushed at the end of the list or at the end of the array. And this is how this bubble sort works, right? So now let me show you another iteration so that the concept is clear. So after the first iteration, the list is 0, 3, 1, 2, 12, and 15. Okay, so once again, values will be compared. No change will happen. Okay, 1, 2, 12, 15. Okay, 3 will be compared to 1. Here, 1 is smaller than 3. So value will be swapped. Right, 15. Okay, then 3 will be compared to 2. Once again, value will be swapped. This will become 2, 3, 12, and 15. Then 3 will be compared to 12. No change will happen. Then we don't need to move further because this part is already sorted. 15 is already the largest number. So here, the second largest number is pushed at the second last position. And this is the end of the second iteration. And this is how we'll continue until the whole list is sorted. Now, I guess the theory part is pretty much clear. Now, let's move on to our system so that we can create our Python program. Okay, so now we are into our editor. So the first thing that we'll do is we'll create a list one variable and then store the list into this. Let this be a random list, okay? And then what we'll do is we'll create a function. Let's name this bubble sort only.
So bubble sort, and then we'll pass this list one as our parameter. Okay, so we'll pass this list one as our parameter, and then we'll create our first for loop, which will extract or select the first number of the unsorted list so that it can be compared to rest of the numbers or rest of the item of the list. Okay, so we are going backwards to the list. This is why we are writing this minus one here. Okay, and then let's create the for loop so that we can iterate through it. So let's create a num variable for num in range. Now if the list one of this num index is greater than the list one of index plus one, then we have to swap those values. So we'll create a temp variable which will store the number for now. So we'll create this num temp variable which will store this number, and then we'll start swapping. Okay, so now as you can see that this is the old school way of swapping the numbers. First of all, creating a temporary variable and storing the data into this, then taking the other data that we want to swap and storing it into the original one, and then saving the data which is in the temporary variable back into the original one. Okay, so I guess this is pretty simple. So now actually the code is done. What we need to do is we need to call this bubble sort function with the list one variable, and then we'll simply print list one variable. Okay, so let's run this, and here you can see that our list is sorted now. Okay, so this was a pretty simple approach to sorting a list. We have already seen that how the insertion and selection sort works. If you haven't seen that video, I'll provide the link below, so you can watch that also. Okay, so this is it for this video, and I'll meet you in my next lecture where we'll create something more awesome. Okay, so meet you there. Bye bye.